Nanotechnology is really the science of working with things at the molecular levels. There's a vast range of technologies that could surely be advanced in really profound ways if we're able to capture technology and devices at the nanoscale.
The grant had the two aims. One was to explore nanoscale phenomenon. The other was to find a way to close gaps in education within nanotechnology, the field. And so once we hit on the idea of using reality-based or virtual reality technologies in order to visualize scientific data, it also became really tantalizing to think about, well, can't this be like a game? Can't you have multiplayer? And then it just one thing led to another. And so we came up with this classroom environment. That's when Nano 2020 loads. Sort of taking the inspiration behind the grant literally. They wanted a classroom technology, so we're like, okay, here's a 3D classroom. The principal thing about Nano 2020, I think, is playing around with scale. So, and the whole point is to learn how to teleport around, basically learn the mechanics of being in VR, and we'll start there. And that what we found is that we can bring people in from different parts of the world, realizing that maybe this could be for education.
Okay, I'm in.
Power of data visualization is not just the ability to tell stories, it's the ability for people from very different backgrounds to experience the data. It obliterates the communication barriers. It allows lots of people from lots of backgrounds to understand what they're looking at.
So across campus and across country, we've developed a series of courses, modules. It's all module-based curriculum so that things can be pulled out and customized depending on the faculty and how they want to use it. It's a really diverse platform, and our intent over time is to make this curriculum not only housed here at the University of Arizona and in the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences, but actually be openly available.
The student involvement is all of it, because the whole point of this program is to band together and to facilitate learning and skill development as rapidly as possible. My favorite part is that the students at the U of A built it entirely. That's it, hands down.